Hey YouTube, Dan Ottawa here, the best third size 4 tier Pokemon Go battler in the world, coming at you with a video on Ultra League teams. I'm going to talk about the Ultra League and Ultra League Remix and give you some non-XL teams to use and some XL teams to use. Going over, because it's all repeat, right? This nothing has changed, and I'm going to show you that there's almost nothing has changed in the Ultra League Remix. So a lot of these teams are probably out there already. So I'm going to go over the teams that worked for me extremely well, go over what I could change to make them better, and give and link the video in the description to the videos that I put out during the Ultra League Remix and Ultra League Open like last season. So before I get to that, I just want to say a quick thanks for the 5,000 subs. We hit that the other day. I wrote it in my community post about like how, like, obviously I'm nowhere as good as Kang or Ryze, and I'm not as good of a showcaster as like Zionic. But what I think I do is I do provide value to the average PvPer. Because right, you got to remember, it's still generally a small percentage of people who hit Legend. And I try and put out teams that are not only like accessible, but usable. And I think where I go beyond is to provide just like an analysis of like how to use a team. Like how do you play certain matchups and different tips and tricks. So I'm hoping, I see a lot of people commenting say like they use this team and it worked well. I think they got the most Legend. So I'm glad I'm helping you out. So thanks for being with me. Thanks as I grow the channel. And now let us talk about Ultra League, Ultra Remix. So what I love about this is the Holiday Cup, because as you can see, it starts today. So 4 p.m. today. But the Holiday Cup starts on the December 16th, and it rolls into like the start of Master League. So you can realistically just play Ultra League for like 3 days, 2 days. Yeah, you can like play Great League this in the morning and then play Ultra League 14, 15, and then play Holiday Cup on the 16th. So if you do not, what I'm going to say right now is I've got a couple XL teams for you to try. Some of them work very well. If you do not have XLs and you do not want to test the non-XL teams that I'm going to put out here, take 2 days off. Honestly, just take off until the Holiday Cup and just play the Holiday Cup. I know a lot of people struggle with this because of the resource requirements, and you're just going against like level 50 Pokemon all like from people who can grind. So if you're having trouble, just don't play. That being said, I'm going to play. So I don't know what teams I'm going to use yet, but let us go over the band, and then let's go over some non-XL teams and then XL teams. So the Ultra League Remix, 10 Pokemon band. So these 10, 9 are the same. The only one, there was Clefable before replaced with Umbreon. It is otherwise the exact same 10. So again, that's what I'm saying. Not much has changed. So you can find probably a lot of teams to go through. And let's go through some non-XL teams. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw out the team that I used. I'll link the video in the description. And then I'll show you the PV poke analysis and then how you can potentially make it better. So the first team I ran was a Shadow Machamp. Gengar and Snorlax, and I used Focus Blast on my Gengar. So I was Focus Blasting everything. So here's the PV poke analysis. So again, you have some coverage, but as you can see, like, you got a lot of coverage right now on your steals, because like between the superpower on Snorlax and the fighting, you cover the steals. And then you got some like weaknesses to Nidoqueen is your three there, and then you got like Scrafty caused a little bit of problems, right? Because it's going to ramp up on Snorlax, and unless you land the Focus Blast on Gengar, which you can, like, I caught a lot of people off guard with running that as like a safe swap. So basically, you can, if you are worried about, because you can also lose, like, you can see Mandibuzz is two problems there. So you can either one replace Gengar with something else, like something a little more tanky, to cover your dark weaknesses there, or instead of just running Focus Blast, if these are going to be losses anyways, run Shadow Ball, because then you can probably pick up other matchups here. I don't know off by heart, but like I assume that if you can run Shadow Ball, you may be able to pick up, I don't know about Jellicent, but like Nidoqueen, maybe if you can land the Shadow Ball there, you'll probably pick up that one. Escav, same thing, like if you land the Shadow Ball there, you'll pick up that one too. So that's the way I would adjust that lineup there if you want to test that out. The second non-XL team that I used that I beat Thoe Technical with, and I just lost to Virgi Virg with, and I got 200 plus ELO with, is Giratina Origin, Kingdra, and Escav. And as you're going to see right now, Escav is a beast. And if you have an Escav, I would build around it because, as you can see, just between like having the counters, it's a counter user that is not weak to charm, right? Because it's got the half steel there, the steel and bug. So the fact that you can like throw these counters to a lot of these, like look at that Lapras, Registeel, Abomasnow, Ferrothorn, right? A lot of Pokemon are weak to counter. And then you're not weak to charm. So that's like a nice trade-off. So I paired it with Giratina Origin and Kingdra because Kingdra is still one of the best safe swaps, in my opinion, in this league. Just because of the Dragon Breath just does so much damage. And then I went the Origin because maybe this, no, Alter does, because Alter is here in the analysis. I think I maybe played this in the Remix Cup where Giratina Altered is banned. So I was running Giratina Origin. But again, it's got a really nice play. So like if you don't have like an altar built, like the Origin has a nice play and it has the Dragon Pulse too, which is a nice sort of like, it's not a nuke, but it's a nice strong moveset there. So this is a team that got me pretty well. Again, link in the description below. And the third team I'm gonna throw up here is, so this is not my exact same team. What it is Sylveon, Hirayama, and Amok. And so what you're gonna see is I ran this team with Empoleon instead of Hirayama. And when I ran Empoleon, I did well with the team, but you have like even like okay matchups like Galarian Stunfisk, it's you're still weak to like ground, right? So having Hirayama in here like gives you those hard wins where you would otherwise lose, right? Against the steals. Plus again, it's a counter user, so you have some just like coverage and bulk going down the line there. So it's a nice Pele there. So just between like Muk and Amok, again, Amok, I think I put like 4 or 5 videos on Amok. Still one of the best safe swaps. I run it with Snarl and Dark Pulse because there are so many, like you got your so many things that are weak to that. Like Trevenant right there, Cresselia is weak to it, Jellicent's weak to it. You can land the Sludge Bomb on the Abomasnow. Yeah, so just like I'd rather like just run with those movesets. It's a super strong Pokemon. Sylveon, again, it just went with a Charmer. You can go with another Charmer or replace it with something else. Just look at sort of your weaknesses here if you don't like running Charmers. And those are the non-XL teams. So I have two XL teams for you. Both did really well for me. And this one, it's a Venusaur double dark. A lot of people, what you will see is Nidoqueen double dark. I actually prefer the Venusaur double dark because if you run Nidoqueen double dark, you leave yourself open to Swampert more, right? Because you're going to have a tough time with Swampert on the lead and against Muk. So that's why I prefer the Venusaur, just for the sort of like wider coverage there. And then again, you have like, so Registeel, why you would run like, I guess Nidoqueen, you can have to land the Earth Power on Registeel anyways. And then Talonflame. You see, so you are weak to like Registeel and Talonflame, so you could replace the Venusaur with something to deal with those. So so Nidoqueen could do it anyways. But the thought process is, if you never run this before, you draw out a fighter, you hard punish with your Nidoqueen slash Venusaur, and then you run in the back. Muk is again, you can run it with Poison Jab this time. I still just run it with Snarl and Dark Pulse just for the wide coverage there. And you are against weak to Ferrothorn. So having something that can cover like Registeel, like your steels, right? And Escav's there too. Is Escav steel? I keep saying it's steel, but this may not be a steel. Maybe just be a bug. Again, don't know. No, it's super weak to fire, so I think it's steel. Anyways. So that is the team there. Again, I did really well with this team. Link in the description. And last one, we have Abomasnow, Swampert, Talonflame. This is, I ran, I called it an accessible XL team. I ran Umbreon, Abomasnow, Talonflame, because all three were technically like Talonflame and Umbreon have had community days, so they were accessible. And Abomasnow, Snover has had like 1.5 million community like different like events, so it was accessible. So I called it this an accessible XL team. Again, you can run Umbreon in here. As you can see, like Swampert picks up some wins, but Swampert is one of those, like, it's Swampert was one of those where It was so strong for so long in this, and it still is. It's still like one of the top ranked. But now that you have like Trevenant, right, as a top Pokemon, so that, and you lose to Talflame, which is like, that's like hit or miss. And now like Jellicent, see like the all these XLs are now like coming up. Greedent's on there, Ferrothorn, Scrafty. So these are all XL Pokemon that generally were not on there before that are now sort of like the staples of Ultra League, which now makes Swampert a little more irrelevant just because it still is a little glassy. Like, it still hits like a truck, so you can still use it. But if you like, I use Umbreon here, which will give you like more coverage on Jellicent, and it keeps you in the Abomasnow and Meganium matchups there as well. So those are the different teams. I have no idea what team I'm gonna run. Quite honestly, I still have not decided what I want to run tomorrow. I'm gonna look through. I'm probably gonna do something with Escav just because I do think Escav has great coverage overall. But I plan to put out, so like I'll put out how many videos? So this is going up Tuesday, which is the 13th. Monday, this is the 13th. So I'll put out a team on the 14th and the 15th. But then the 16th is when Holiday Cup starts. So I want to put out teams for Holiday Cup for you because I think the majority of people will go to the Holiday Cup. So I'm gonna put out teams on the 16th. So I'll throw out two teams for Ultra League and Ultra League Remix. I don't know which one I'm gonna play yet. And then the rest will be team ideas for Holiday Cup and then a bunch of Holiday Cup teams because Ultra League Remix and Ultra League has been done way too many times. So you need teams for Ultra League for Holiday Cup, and I think it's gonna be more fun. So I'm gonna run a bunch of those. Let me know if you have any teams that you are gonna try for Ultra League or Ultra League Remix that work that you want me to like maybe try out on mine. And if not, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.